Now then people, it's Lee from Jorvik Mudcraft. I'm back out in the woods today. Thought I'd come out because considering it's December, it's not too bad actually out here. I've just got my bag set up there. I'm going to get a brew on in a minute. Decided to stop here because I'm going to do a couple of reviews. But I'm just looking at the state of it round here, all this left. I believe it's army do train here, like I said before. They do own it as well, but does that give them the right to leave it in such a state? I don't know. Personally, I think it's a bit bad order, but yeah. So what we're going to do today is we're going to have a brew first, and then I've got a couple of items that I've been wanting to do reviews on for a while. Well, not reviews really, but tests for myself, and hopefully be able to help other people. So yeah, we'll crack on. I'll have my brew, and then we'll get a couple of things out what I've bought recently. Okay, see you soon. So I'm trying out one of these alcohol blocks, and let it get going a bit. Yeah, I've got a gas stove as well, but I just thought I'd try this out. See how long it takes to boil a cup of water. No, it's not sturdy, yes, but bad, it's hot already. Sorry about that. So as you can see, it's burning away in there. Actually, got a top for that, which will let it boil a bit quicker. That amazed me how hot that got so quick. It really did get hot quick. So there's my top to put on. And I'll give you an update on how long that takes to boil. I'll bring you back soon. Okay, so 11:33, we put this on to boil, and it's a bit awkward to get the top off. It seems to seal into it, but there we go. As you can see, 11:42, a rolling boil. I'm going to transfer that into my other cup. Stick that back on there, put some water in. Sorry. Okay, so we'll pop some more water in there. What we're going to do now while that's still hot and while it's boiling again, we're going to put the meal on. So I'll bring you back in just 1 second. Okay folks, so there we go, there we have a wrap pack, which is where the coffee and whitener and sugars come from, a wrap pack coffee. Beautiful. Right, so what I'm going to do, because that one looks like it's dying down a bit, I'm going to lift that off. I'm going to put a another one on. Sorry. No, I'm not. Right, I've actually swapped to my stove. I don't think that was going to get this to a boil. I've got to be at a boil for about 8 minutes. That didn't last 8 minutes, so I was going to do it on that, see if that would cook my beans and pork sausages. But it won't, so I've swapped to my gas stove. But it's always good to know that you've got the old alcohol things, which will do you a brew at least, if you run out of gas. So, we'll have a bit of breakfast and then we'll get on with doing these, get a couple of tools out and give them a bit of use. Hi people, Lee from Jorvik Mud's Craft. Like I said, I was going to do a couple of reviews, and this is the first review that I'm going to do. These are 511 Taclite Pro trousers, which I come across, and they're 65% polyester and 35% cotton. They're like, if you can see, I'll zoom in, a ripstop material. You've got a, depends where you're from obviously, they're sold worldwide, a magazine if you're in America, folded knife, or even a mobile phone pocket there, nicely stitched around, really strong, good stitching in them. Okay, you've got a belt loop here, you can hang a knife, set of keys, anything like that from. Quite a nice touch. On the pockets, as you can see, they're all well stitched, and they've got these, it's like extra fibre here, so if you were hanging a, maybe a knife off there or something, it's going to protect your pockets. We've got elasticated waist for comfort and movability, which I do find them extremely comfortable as a trouser. I normally wear them when I come out, but these are crag hoppers. We've got a double gusset in the leg to allow for movement, so you can get your leg, cock your leg up nice and high when you're climbing other things out in the wilderness. I got a good sized side pocket, which is just on a Velcro. Fit various items in there, and they've got double protection on the knees. They've also got a pocket in the knee to fit some neoprene knee pads, which I've just bought actually. They haven't landed yet, otherwise I'd have popped them in and tried them and reviewed them. But as you can see, they're like double sewn on the knees to give extra protection. Another side pocket here with a Velcro tab. Really, really strong Velcro as well. If you buy cheap stuff, you can find that the Velcro just isn't quite strong enough, and after a short while it stops velcroing down. But as you can see, all these are really well stitched on. Flies are coming out a bit today. Another magazine stroke knife stroke mobile phone pocket there. Nice big bit of velcro on them, again really well stitched. The other pocket at this side has also got your extra protection on for if you're hanging a knife off. I'm just going to turn these over. Okay, you've got these angled, again at the back, you've angled pockets at the back which are on a bit of a weird angle, being honest with you. Open the Velcro up. Big, big, deep pockets. Sorry, the problem. Big, deep pockets, you get all sorts in them. Let me see, hopefully. Just on a bit of a weird angle, if anything. But again, if you wanted to hang your folding knife off it, set of car keys, anything you really thought you could do with hanging off there. Also, it's good to see that there's extra protection in the bum area. So if you're sitting down on logs, like I have been over there, having my breakfast, yeah, gives you a bit of extra protection, which I think is absolutely great. Second side pocket on this side, exactly the same. Nice strong Velcro up, so nothing's going to fall out. Big, big, deep pocket, keep stuff in. Then you've got a strap. I do not know what the strap's for. I guess it's for if you, I don't know, if you fall into a hole, a crevice, somewhere like that, it give you a good pull up. But yeah. So that's them. That's the 511 Taclite pants. Taclite Pro, sorry. 511 Taclite Pro pants, which I've worn and I can strongly recommend. You get these belt, look at the size of them belt buckles. I mean, they're really good. Double sewn on everything. Nice. You've sewn four times on the back one. It's not quite as thick. It's still falling off. There's nowhere dry to put them, so I've just had to hang them over my bag. But yeah, really good, really nice. I'm gonna turn these back over for you, just so you can have a look at this side. Good zipper in them. Not YKK, but it's still a good zipper. And they do them in various colours. I went for green, obviously. I don't know why, I spend a lot of time in the woods. People go for green stuff. But that's a lovely edge on there as well. Hanging stuff off there. But yeah, I just thought I'd show you around these and give you my opinion. I think they're a very good trouser. And yeah, I'm not sponsored in any way by anybody. Just want you to know that. But yeah, just wanted to share that with you, and if you fancy some, I think you'll not be disappointed. Thank you very much for watching. Now then, I've just invested in a Fiskers X7 axe, which I have wanted for a while. I got it off the internet for about £25. If you look around, they're all different prices. But I brought it out today to give it a go. It says safety boots, safety goggles, made in Finland. So it comes with this cavy sheath. Not the best. I think it'd have been nicer with a within a proper leather one, being honest, but it is what it is. So let's get it out of the sheath and have a go with it. So we've got a bit of wood here, which we're going to see what sort of a delve we're getting. Somebody has already been having a go at it. It's pretty punked up, it's been here a while. But it's all I've got, so let's have a look how she goes. I'll go into this delve that somebody's already made. biting straight in. You can feel it really making a difference there. Look at the difference that's made, and that's just with a few swipes. Yeah, it's a bit punky wood, but the way this is beveled, it's ideal for splitting, and it's it comes really sharp, and so it's gone straight in there, no problem whatsoever. Yeah, it's a few more strikes, here we go. As you can see, that's made a massive hole. Get rid of some of that debris, and you can just see it's yeah, well impressed. Well impressed. So this is the X7, which is 640 grams. It's classed as a camping stroke hiking axe. It's not too heavy for the old bag. It does say on it not to bang on there for when you're splitting wood. But I'm sure if you were just hitting it with other wood, it would probably be all right. Unfortunately, where I am, there's no logs as such to show you on there. To show you splitting, I'll have to try and find some logs somewhere. The handle here, it's high grip, and it's comfy. And it is grippy. I wasn't slipping too much there. I put a lanyard on there when I get home, probably. And yeah, first impressions are it's a really, really nice little camping axe. I'm going to have a quick look around and see if I can't find some stumps of wood to chop in half to make some, little logs. And I'll have a go. I'll come back to you in a minute.